In this video on how to use Zoom on iPad, I will show you 5 essential actions that you can do on Zoom. How to install Zoom on iPad from App Store, how to join a meeting on iPad, how to create an account from Zoom on iPad, how to create a meeting on Zoom for iPad, and the last, how to create a scheduled meeting on Zoom for iPad. So let's start. Zoom is a great app for online meetings, conferences, and webinars. For you to install Zoom on iPad, you will need to go to the App Store, find it, and tap on it. Here, on the search, write Zoom and search it. Now that you found the app, tap Get. It will ask you your password or your fingerprint. Complete the requirements. Now wait. After the install is complete, just tap on Open. You have installed Zoom on the iPad. The next step is to join a meeting or just sign up for a new account, or sign in into your old account on iPad. If you wish to enter into a meeting, you will need to have the ID of the meeting and also, if needed, a password. Find this info from the host. For you to join a meeting, you need to tap the big blue button, Join a meeting. Tap the ID of the meeting on the top, write it. You can also select what join option you wish from the list. Now, tap on Join Meeting. If the meeting has a password, it will appear this pop-up. Write the password and tap OK. If the meeting has not started yet, you will get a screen with a message saying, waiting for host. Please wait until the host starts the meeting. You cannot do anything now. If the meeting is starting and you are the first time on Zoom, it will ask you to agree to the terms of service. Tap I agree. Now Zoom will ask you some permissions. Now tap OK to the camera permission. You can join a meeting with a video or without. Let's tap Join with video. Now tap OK to microphone permission. Now tap Allow to notification permissions. Now you have joined a meeting. Just tap on Call using Internet Audio to join with audio. You can start audio and video from the top buttons. Tap on Join Audio to join with audio and then start video to see and hear yourself in the meeting. Before you create the account on Zoom for iPad, you will need to install the app from App Store. Tap on Sign Up link from the bottom. Write the email on the first field. Then write the first name and the last name. Check that you agree to the terms of service from Zoom. Now tap on Sign Up from the top. Now tap OK. You will receive an email to verify your account. Just check your email to continue with the next step. I will go to the Gmail app on the phone. Here we have the email that we received from Zoom. Now tap on Activate Account. If this notification appears, tap on Agree and Proceed. And then close. On this page, you can edit your name and also create a password for your new account. Just write the password and then confirm the password. I will skip this part for you not to see my password. Now, tap on Continue. Here, let's skip this step. I do not wish for now to invite anyone. Your new account is ready. Let's get back to the app so we can log in. Tap on Sign In. Here, write your email and password and hit Sign In. Tap OK for Zoom to access your calendar. This is very useful so Zoom can add reminders into your calendar app. If you wish to allow Siri to use Zoom, tap OK. If not, tap Don't Allow. I'll tap OK. You can save your password to log in faster if you wish. You can also enable Fingerprint ID if your tablet has this. I will tap OK. Your new account is ready to be used. If you wish to create a new meeting on Zoom, just follow these steps. Tap on the New Meeting button from the top. Here, you can set up the meeting to be with video or not. For the ID, you can use your ID or just generate a new one. If you leave this option unchecked, then every time you will get a different ID for your meeting. So you will have to send every time this new ID to the person who you invite to the meeting. Now tap on Start the meeting. Now you have started the meeting. Tap on Call using Internet Audio to activate the audio for this meeting. Now you have started the meeting. You can invite others by pressing on Participants and the button Invite. Also, here you have the option to mute all and chat with people. Also, you can tap on the three dots and select Meeting Settings to make any adjustments to the meeting. Here, you have lots of settings. If you wish to mute all participants on entry, just tap on this option. If you want not to allow others to join the meeting, just tap on option Lock Meeting. Also, you can allow others to rename themselves and to share files. After you have checked all the options, just tap Done from the top. This is the new meeting that you can invite others to join. To schedule a meeting, just tap Schedule button from the top. Here you can give a name for your meeting. Now, select a date. You can also select the start time for the meeting and the duration for this. You can make so this meeting will repeat depending on your needs. Also, you can set up an end date for the repeats. If you will enable Use Personal ID, the meeting ID will be the same as your account. If not, every time you start the meeting, the ID will be reset and you will generate a new one. Also, you can set up a password if you wish here. You can disable also the password for the meeting if you want. After that, you can set up that the video for the host to be on and also the video for the participants. After you have selected all of the options you wish, just tap Done from the top. Now you can add this new schedule meeting to your calendar so you will not forget. After you do the adjustments on this event, just tap Add. To start the schedule meeting, just tap on Meetings from the left. Here, tap Start for the meeting. Now, tap on Call using Internet Audio to activate the microphone. If you tap on the three dots and select Meeting Settings, you can set up more options for this meeting. There are lots of useful features like Mute on Entry, so that user have audio disabled on entry. Also other options like Allow persons to chat. You can check them as the options are quite well explained. After this, you can add also invites to the persons by tapping on Participants button and then Invite option. Now you have prepared your scheduled meeting. If this was useful, please like, share and subscribe. Also, if you have any questions, please ask them on the comments area below.